Holy sh! Hello everyone, welcome back, it's your boy Grim Cookies. I am here with a video. I haven't done a custom content reaction review video in so long, and I am absolutely thrilled for this one. Okay, so Little Deka is literally an icon in the community. Well known for his massive behemoth sized custom content collections that are always like ridiculously good, like not believably good. Like when I first saw the work in progress videos or GIFs that he posted on Twitter of this custom content, I thought he was doing like mock-ups in Blender of just having fun. I was like, no, that can't be custom content because it literally doesn't, it looks too good. Like that can't be for The Sims. My mind is literally exploding and I haven't even fully looked at everything yet. This is incredible. You guys are gonna absolutely love this and I'm really excited to show it to you. It's available on his Patreon right now and you guys know, as I always say, supporting creators is so important. So if you want this custom content and of course if you can afford to support Little Deka on Patreon, absolutely do it. The link's in the description. Let's jump in because I'm so excited and you guys, you're gonna lose your mind just as much as I'm losing mine, okay? Let's go. Okay, so this is me reacting to the trailer for the first time that he posted on YouTube. It already has 6,000 views and it was only posted literally today. Okay, so I'm clicking play right now. It's called Greasy Goods, by the way. It's fast food themed. The quality looks incredible. I'm so excited for the lot. The one he did last time was so amazing. This looks ridiculously good. I don't understand how anybody has this level of talent because, like, it's crazy. It's like everything's animated. Those toilets, though. Why does this look better than literally everything ever? I'm so excited for this. Wow, look at that wallpaper. That looks incredible. Oh my god, that logo. I love it. This looks... I'm actually blown away, like properly. 70 new items is ridiculously huge. Like, 70. How is that even possible? We're gonna look at all 70. This is incredible. I'm like literally up. Holy sh! Okay, so it's like horrible weather to be doing this, but I don't have any mods in, so I can't change it. But I'm here, I made myself a little bit smaller just because I didn't want to get in the way of the custom content. I thought we would do a tour of the lot that comes with this pack first. So if you go into Little Deka's gallery, he's already uploaded the lot. You need the custom content for it to work, obviously, but you can just download it straight from his library and you've literally got this bougie looking fast food restaurant to go in your game. It literally has like a children's playground area and everything. I'm like so impressed by this. Okay, so let's do a tour. Obviously this is the front door down here. So you arrive, you've got these outdoor seating benches. I love the colors. Like the black, red, white and yellow, it just screams fast food in a way that like, it doesn't look like McDonald's. But like the colors invoke that feeling that you get from McDonald's and kind of fast food in general. And it's like incredible the way that he's translated it without like having it be literally a recreation of like any one particular fast food chain. He's literally just made like, oh my God, there's like even rubbish deco. It's so realistic. So you've got these ordering machines like you have now, and they're literally animated, which is like, I can't believe that. I didn't even think that was possible for custom content to do that. So you walk through the front door and we've got these, oh, it's a bin. That's so cool. I was like, what is it? It's a bin. That's incredible. Okay, so you walk through, you've got the seating area with that really cool looking divider. That's something special. You've got an upstairs area. I'm assuming more seating. Yep, and more bins. This looks so nice. Absolutely incredible. We've got a storage room in here. That looks fantastic. Through here, a bathroom. This might be like my favorite part. Look at these urinals. We don't even have urinals in The Sims 4 yet. Like, that's incredible. And like the little slippery sign, it's just like, you know, it's such a cohesive set. Everything works together. It all looks like it belongs into the one theme. It's just so high quality. It's ridiculous. Oh my god, even that burger sign. Isn't that just like it though? Isn't that like literally like what fast food restaurants are like these days? Like they went from being really tacky in like the 90s and now, oh, we got some rubbish there. And now they're all trying to be like bougie and fancy and like it's literally a burger place, like calm down. Okay, so we come downstairs into the main ordering area. We've got an entrance out the back as well. I love the use of platforms here. This too is so realistic and it looks fantastic. Oh my god. Okay, hold on. So, you know how in The Sims 4 Dine Out you had that ugly, clunky, like, booth where the person had to stand in order to seat everybody? So he has separated that, put it on a counter, and now you walk up to literally like a register and then you're seated. Like, that is so cool. Those boards look incredible as well. I'm actually so impressed by this. Okay, let's have a look at the kitchen. Look at that though. Everything's animated and it looks incredible. The sauce packets. I hope sweet and sour is in there. It's the best sauce. The fryers. Okay, so these are not functional in that your Sims can't cook on them because we don't have like anything like that for him to use as a base. But like, so for him to go through so much effort in making such high quality decoration items, they don't exist for any other purpose other than for you to build a really good build with them. Like, that is so impressive. And that's like a level of quality that like is unparalleled. Like, Little Deka is just, he's in his own league, man. I absolutely can't believe this. Like, it is so Maxis Match, and yet it's so much more detailed than actual Maxis Match items. no shade there, but like, this is incredible. Oh my god. Just like, can we just take a moment to look at that oil frying, like bubbling? As if. The chips, they look really delicious. The burgers. Oh my god. This just looks so good. Is that a bin or is that decoration? I'm not sure. I think it's decoration. That's fine. And then you've got this here, which is the where they actually cook, which is a clone of the one from Dine Out. That just looks absolutely incredible. I'm so impressed by this. It's not funny. We come through here, we've got more seating. Obviously, it's a fast food restaurant, so there's nothing like... It looks deceptively simple. So, we're going to have a jump through now to an empty lot. I'm going to put all the items out and we'll go through them individually. Okay, so I'm here. I didn't even realize, but we got a whole new set of... why are my walls glitching out? That's weird. Doors and windows. So we have this one here. We've got, they're kind of all, like, interchangeable, I guess. Like, they fit, like, really well with each other is what I'm trying to say. So you could, like, do some really cool things with these. I like them. They're, like, really good. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 new wallpapers, which are all really fantastic. My favorite one's probably this, like, collage one. It just looks really cool. We've got new tiles, new, like, subway tiles, like some concrete style ones, and then these like sliding, which are really cool. We've also got 4 new, what are they called? Flooring, that come in a bunch of like really awesome colors as well. So that's all really, really awesome. So let's jump into the first item. We've got a faux leather seat. This has some really high quality texturing on it. Let me like try and make it really large so you can see. Like, look at the leather, like detailing on that. That looks fantastic. That is really, really good. We've got the eye comfort plastic molded chair. This is really cool as well. Doesn't this just look like those exact ones they have in real life? Like, I don't know about America and the UK, but these look pretty spot on to the real life ones at McDonald's here in Australia. We've got this really awesome booth seating. The swatches are all really, really cool as well. And some of them are pretty neutral. You could use these in situations outside of a fast food restaurant. And they would look pretty fantastic. Let me kind of like move it out of the way. Next up, we've got a stool, which looks really nice too. That has the leather detailing on it as well, which is really impressive again. Absolutely love it. Next up, we've got a counter. And this is like a fully like completed counter set, which is like, that's rare. Like, it's rare for the Sims team to put in the effort to give us one of these. And like, Little Deka does it like every single time he releases a set. It's just incredible. We've got a dining table, a bar dining table. We've got so this is a six seater, but he's separated them so that it looks like really close pushed together two seaters, which are really, really cool. So we've got same again. That's all really awesome. We've got a picnic bench style one. That looks fantastic too. Absolutely love it. So we've got obviously a urinal, which is just really, really cool. We've got a toilet as well. This one looks like the base game toilet. I'm sure he's done something different. I'm probably just not recognizing it. Or it could just be a recolor to like kind of match with the fast food color scheme. But that looks like the base game one to me, which is fine. We've got that burger decal, obviously. It comes in a bunch of different colors. So you could have, you've got like burger or fancy dining, basically, which is, that's really cool as well. So here we got the H&B Pro Industries Chips Warmer, which looks fantastic. And remember, these are all animated. They only come in one swatch. I don't actually dislike that though, because the stainless steel look is like pretty universal. Like, I don't even know what else I would want this in. We've got obviously the preparation station with heating cabinet for the burgers. We've got the patty press grill. That's where you cook the burgers. I thought it was a sandwich press when I first saw it, but it's like a burger press. That's really cool. We've got a six basket fryer, which looks fantastic as well. We've got the Duck Dan end piece. These are named after like that Duck Dan guy, isn't it? Aren't they? I'm pretty sure I saw a joke about that on Twitter. But so we've got a whole like ducted kind of ceiling set. He's made one of these before, I believe, but this one is like solid. I really like that. That's one of those things to go on the roof. We've got a urinal divider to go over these, which is really cool. What's it called? They're not looking. That's funny. So we've got a whole bunch of decoration stuff. This is going to be so good for those of you who are like really detailed builders. So we've got like individual sauce packets. We've got burger boxes. We've got a fries thing. We've got an open burger box. We've got a salt shaker. We've got toilet stall walls, and doors. These are functional, even if you don't have the pack that the toilet university, I'm pretty sure they're functional without university, but some of this stuff requires dine out. We've got a wet floor sign, which is really cool. A napkin holder. This is like, the attention to detail here is like so good. Fast food serving tray. That's really awesome as well. And then we've got like all of the food. So you've got milkshake thing and the swatches as well. Like, so good. Chicken Supreme burger, 8-pack of nuggets. I'm actually really hungry for some nuggets after seeing them. We've got like a big like Whopper style burger. These look really delicious. we've got that kiosk. I'm not sure if this is functional. No, it's not. That's fine. I feel like what works is that what is functional makes everything you need anyway. And then like all of the extra decorations just kind of like complete the set, which is just awesome. So we've got the kiosks, obviously, hand dryer. We've got that logo. Is it just the, it comes in a bunch of swatches too. That's really handy. We've got the menu display, comes in heaps of different variations. One thing I would have liked is if the overall branding, like this red black color scheme that we're seeing there, if we got swatches that had different colors, because we've kind of got like in all of the wallpaper and like, you know, the different cups, you've kind of got like, you've got the red theme and then you've got pink, blue, and like a different one as well. And so like you've got some items to make like different looking builds, but then some items only have the kind of red theme going on. So that's like literally the one spot where I would be like wanting more, but we already have enough. He's already blessed us with enough, so I can't complain. We have the Greasy Goods sign, which is really cool. This one comes in black and white as well as that red theme, so that's really good. We've got a room divider. That looks really cool too. And then we've got these stylish room dividers, which are just so cool. And they come in plain swatches too. So again, that'll be really handy for those of you who download this and want to use the assets outside of a fast food themed build. We've got a spotlight. That's going to be really handy. Obviously can't see it at the moment because I'm outside. We've got a shaft light. We've got ceiling like hanger lamps. Those are really cool as well. Like these in black would look really good in like a modern build. We've got the fast food chef station. This is the one that's functional to dine out if you've got that pack. If you don't have dine out, you can still download a version of this set that doesn't include the functional parts, but you still get the objects, I believe. They just don't work with the dine out gameplay. So we've got a fast food waiter station, the host station, which are those, I can't put it down anywhere, but the kiosk that we saw earlier. We've got the trash can that's in the wall. That is so cool. Like, that is so cool. And then we've got the door set. So that is all of the items. It is just, it's deceptive. So looking at this, you don't think, oh, that's 70, but there are so many assets here. This would have taken months and months to make. Like, the amount of work that has gone in here is absolutely incredible. Like, I'm once again blown away. Little Deka is taking this custom content community by storm, setting a new standard. Just such an awesome creator and so talented too. I can't wait to see what he does next, as always, because it's just always incredible. I'm very much looking forward to it. These sets alongside Hey Harry and Felix Andres are just like so incredibly good. So it's so awesome. So this is coming out free for public release eventually. I don't have that date on me as I'm recording this, but I'll write it in the description of the video. If you want to grab it now, I have the hiccups all of a sudden, sorry. If you want to grab it now, it is up on his Patreon, but it'll be up for free eventually too. But as I said at the start of the video, if you would like to support him, I absolutely encourage you to do it, because if anyone deserves it, if anyone puts the time and effort in, it's this creator. Little Deka, you are amazing if you end up watching this. Okay, so I'm Grim Cookies. Let me know down in the comments what you guys like about this and what you're going to use these assets for. What type of fast food restaurant are you going to build with them? Are you going to do something else with it, maybe creative? Are you going to build like a really bougie, fancy fast food restaurant? Or are you going to do like a really messy, like kind of not well kept one? This is just so awesome. Thank you so much for watching. You can check out some more videos right now.